Okay, I'm looking forward to this. Very funny man, great portrayals in Naked Gun of comedy, fine acting, fine timing. Let's welcome Leslie Neilson.
Nice to see you indeed.
So far, it's been madness all the way. I'm expected to conduct a nice, quiet interview with you.
It was certainly, he's a remarkably talented guy.
He's mad.
Oh, he is crazy. There's no doubt about that. He's the kind of person I think who would do anything for a laugh. but that's what comedy is, I understand. Ronald Reagan apparently said at one point.
Pardon?
Ronald Reagan,
yeah.
Apparently said at one point, he says, I've caught on to it now. It has to be just like show business.
Yes.
What you have to do is you have to have a good opening, a middle, and a good closing.
Yes.
So as long as you have a good opening, you're on the way. I figure that's... Yeah. Have we gotten to the question and answer period yet?
We're not getting into the questions yet.
I see.
I want you to feel really good first.
Okay. All right, I feel pretty good, though. Very good. Thank you.
Okay. I assume this is this little thing here you have. What is it? Come on, Leslie. Own up. What is that? It's a kind of a mobile whoopee cushion, isn't it?
That's a little personal. But you might call it that, yes. You want me to show it to the audience?
Show it.
You ready? There it is. No, it was something that I actually developed at one time to work on my wrist. I had a very bad accident, so I worked on this device, which, you know, it has little hole in, and it expels the air, and you can, you know, increase or decrease the pressure. And I'm going to get it patented, you know, as soon as I can get the kinks worked out.
Yeah. It's going to be wonderful, that is, when you go to the palace. It's going to be a lot of strange looks.
I spent a lot of time, well, not very much time lately, in the waiting rooms of doctors. They don't even let me stay in there any longer. Excuse me.
Are you going to put
didn't
that
Didn't you think that Charles did a beautiful English dialect there?
Pardon?
That Charles Fleischer, didn't he do a beautiful dialect there?
I thought it was absolutely wonderful.
Quite right, yes. Well, let's not talk about him anymore.
We'll talk about you?
Yes, okay.
All right. Now, you must be very happy about this whole new career as a comedian. I mean, well, comedian, comedy actor.
I love it. I've always been a closet comedian.
Did you study to be a dancer?
No, you see, that's something he's got. I used to go to the Neighborhood Playhouse in New York, and Martha Graham, who is one of the modern dancers of all time, and she taught dancing there, and so it was part of my resume or my bio that I studied dancing out of Martha Graham.
I'm not going to ask you,
can't
you dance?
Well, I can't dance. You ever see anybody in tights who's bow-legged?
You're bow-legged?
I'm bow-legged. You know, you're not going to get me in tights. I'm not going to do any dancing. That was one of the saddest times in my life when it suddenly dawned on me that I was bow-legged. Do you know what that did to me? That meant to me that I could never be Tarzan's son. Never. Yeah.
You've been filming
You know, Fleischer said about it would be nice to see Jack Nicholson play Tarzan.
Interesting.
Yeah. Be more interesting if he played Jane. But that's just a show, observation like that.
You've been doing a new film in Thailand.
We did one over in Thailand, and it's I play the opposite of Frank Drebin. I play the kind of like the scuzzball heavy of all time, Colonel Chi. And in the early part of the film, in a flashback, they see that I get stepped on by a war elephant, and it crushes my arm and does bad things to the side of my face. So I wear a mask all the way through it, and I have an arm that is like a Dr. Strangelove arm that.
Oh,
he's going for my throat.
Oh,
wow. It's pretty crazy. It's called Surfing Ninjas of the South China Sea.
Hey.
Now, you realize, of course, with that title, you're going to rush to see it. It's funny. Very funny.
And that'll be out soon?
I don't know.
Don't be out. People are going to be wild with you.
It's lovely to talk.
Leslie, I'm sure you're going to know the lady we're bringing on next. Like yourself, she's made... been making comedy movies recently, and she's got this great sense of humor. She did Young Frankenstein, Tootsie, as well as starring in Close Encounters of the Third Kind, and lots of things. Please welcome Terri Garr, ladies and gentlemen. Lovely lady.
Hi.
How are you, Linda?
Yeah, thanks.
What'd you do? Your lymph on there.
I don't know. I have something pulled in my leg, but I'm going to ignore it.
Oh, and the so true pro. You're going to hobble through the pain.
Yes.
You're used to this stuff during chat shows, aren't you?
Yes,
you
I am.
You did Eight with Letterman. David Letterman, I was told. And I was told that you did one of these in a shower. An interview, oh, you were in a shower?
On the David Letterman show once, he talked me into taking a shower. It was just a big nightmare.
Bring the shower on.
No.
Well, you actually did an interview in
a... You know, the truth is he was doing a show in his office, and it was kind of dull, and he showed me the desk and the windows and the bathroom, and he said, there's a shower if you want to take a shower. I said, no, I don't want to take a shower. But he kept bugging me the whole thing, so I said, all right, I'll take a shower. And it became like the biggest, you know, it was...
Well, of course it would be. Not many people are interviewed in the shower.
That's true. But, you know, I do a lot of chat shows, as you call them.
Yeah, we call them.
And I've done, in England, I've done the Ruby Wax show, and Jonathan Roth, is that his name?
Roth, W-R-O-T-H.
Oh, right. And the other one, Terri Wogan. Whatever
Wiegand.
His name
it's
is.
Jonathan Roth
They're
and Terri Wiegand.
They're not believe me, are they?
Michael Ospos. They're really...
Well, and Des O'Connor now. Uh-huh. Whenever I do these shows, I always say, you know, I'm very, very big in the United States. And then when I come to the United States, I say, you know, I'm very, very big in England and Australia. There's no way of proving it. And now I'm very confused because here I am in Hollywood doing a show that's only ever seen in England. What should I do, Leslie?
What?
He's not even listening to me. He could care less.
You've met Bill Clinton, haven't you?
Yes,
I have. What's he like?
Oh, very nice and very straightforward and honest and accessible. And you ask him questions about the economy and he comes right up with an answer. Like,
is he a good saxophone player?
I thought so. I was on that Arsenio Hall show, and he played the saxophone when I was on the show.
He sounded good to me.
It was pretty damn good, yeah. Right. I don't know if a person can play the saxophone that well can also be president. Mm-hmm. But I think they can.
What about the White House? You've been to the White House, haven't you?
Yes, and I've been to the White House to a...
Interesting for the British people. You may have told us on an American show before. But we don't know. I mean, how did you get to go to the White? How did you get an invite? What happened?
You tell me, how do you get to go to the palace? Have you been there?
Oh, every weekend I'm up there. What have you been working on lately?
Well, nothing. I've just joined the great ranks of the unemployed here in
Los Angeles.
Well, let me see. I do some television movies. I did a series here for a while, which didn't last very long. And now I'm between engagements, as we say.
You directors and producers, this lady is between engagements. Shouldn't be long.
No, it shouldn't.
Listen, I'm interested that you two both dance. You wouldn't care to give us a finale and do a tango or something.
He's very angry.
I'm only kidding. Well, we wish you both lots of success with your career. When you come to England, come on the show again. Ladies and gentlemen, Terri Garr and Leslie Neilson.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We'll be back in a couple of minutes with Whitney Houston. Don't go away.